call tonight from the spectrum in Philadelphia. In fact, the Eastern Regional Semifinals of the NCAA Tournament. Game one tonight, and you'll see it in just a couple of moments. Syracuse against Iowa. Game two later on tonight, Georgetown against Maryland. The two winners then meet here Sunday afternoon. The overall winner goes to the Final Four next weekend in Indianapolis. Bucky Waters in the first game. Syracuse against Iowa on paper. It looks like Syracuse is inside power, indeed, against Iowa's outside speed.
Right, Bill, and both teams are led in this game by All-Americans. For the Hawkeyes of Iowa, All-American guard Ronnie Lester, the 16th senior, without 15 games with a knee injury. Without him, Iowa was 8-7. With him, they're 13-1. The all-time Iowa scorer, swift and exciting. For the Orange, Roosevelt Bowles, the 6'11", 240-pound senior All-American, is their leading scorer at 15 points a game, but his strength is on the D. On four different occasions, he's had 8 rejects in a single game. 69 for the season, a superb athlete.
And Bucky, Iowa play has been a red-hot ball club coming into this tournament out of the Big Ten. Iowa wound up its regular season, won its last 2 regular season games, has won 2 games now in the NCAA field. Syracuse, the number 6 team in the country, has won 26 games out of 29 plays. And we'll have the team introduction right after these messages. And then added NC State to its victory list, downing NC State 77-64. On the other hand, Syracuse whacked Villanova and had kind of an easy time of it last weekend as Syracuse beat the Wildcats 97-83. Now we've got the introduction of the starting lineup as we pick up right now Tony DiSabato.
Welcome to Philadelphia and the 1980 NCAA East Regional Semifinals. Here are the starting lineup for this evening's first game. Starting at forward for Iowa, a 6'5 fresh junior, number 32, Vince Brookins. At forward for Syracuse, a 6'8 senior, number 55, Lewis Orr. For Iowa, a 6'6 sophomore, number 40, Kevin Boyle. For Syracuse, a 6'5 freshman, number 40, Eric Santifer. Starting at center for Iowa, a 6'10 junior, number 54, Steve Crofterson. At center for Syracuse, a 6'11 senior, number 50, Roosevelt Bowie. Starting at guard for Iowa, a 6'2 sophomore, number 30, Kenny Arnold. For Syracuse, at guard, a 6'2 junior, number 23, Marty Head. For Iowa, a 6'2 senior, number 12, Ronnie Lester. For Syracuse, a 6'2 junior, number 22, Eddie Moss. The Iowa coach, Lute Olson. For Syracuse, Jim Boeheim. The officials, Paul Galvin, Booker Turner, and Dale Kelly.
All right, we'll be back with the tip-off of tonight's first game right after these messages.
If you're looking for an easy way to make a living, being an equipment dealer isn't it. My dad taught me that. He ran this white dealership before me. He taught me a lot of other things, too, like integrity and honesty and pride in your work. And he taught me that if you're going to deal with farmers, you have to be willing to work as long and as hard as they do. That's why I'm here tonight, And that's why I'll be here tomorrow.
This is starting 6'10" junior Steve Waite, but instead going, as you saw, with a 6'5" junior who has more scoring power than Brookins. Cooley at the left, last person at the right, and it goes the ball of Iowa, driving right to the foul line. 2-0 Iowa. That quickly, Kevin Boyle of Chicago.
Iowa likes the up-tempo. They're much better in transition, and that substitution may indicate a lot of pressure by the Hawkeyes.
Well, we mentioned when we signed the broadcast on a Syracuse head of course, the good inside power with Bowie. Don't forget that Syracuse also has the pretty good outside shooter, like that guy right there, Marty Head, and the rebound goes to Brookins of Iowa. Iowa with an early lead. Leads the slightly favored Syracuse Orangemen by a score of 2-0. Arnold on a fake and then shoots overhead, still 2-0. Rebound is Bowie at Syracuse. The lead pass deflected by Taft Sisson, taken by Lester to the top of the key. To Brookins from the right of the key, 4-0. Brookins, he is leading. He is a 6'5" senior. He's a big shooter there. He hit 7 straight against NC State in the second half, 17 overall, to bring Iowa from 3 down to beat NC State in Greensboro. All right, drive into the hoop, and the lane is good by Eric Satterfield. And Syracuse pressures the inbound pass, but Brookins flying down the floor. 4-2, Iowa. Iowa with great outside position. The fifth position has the ball right now. Ronnie Lester, 6'2", senior, senior out of Chicago. To the hoop goes Lester. Feet off, and Boyle makes the 6'2". Boyle That time Lester posted up with Eddie Moss. Both are 6'2", and Lester can get him from anywhere. Boyle playing Sadler. Brookins fairly tight door. Bowie with a 12-footer, and it's a 6-4 game. Bowie from 12-foot range, and we have played 2 minutes of the opening half. Brookins to the foul line, into the lane, changing hands. The rebound is Bowie, and there's going to be a foul on Brookins of Iowa. That is the first personal of the evening.
Brookins has been an excellent sixth man for Iowa. Here he makes his move to the hoop, throwing up the soft left-hander. Not a great shot, and hung on the rim. Very anxious to get back in there and get that soft rebound. He gets called for coming over the back. I will make this observation. It appears early on that the officials are going to let him play, and I think the fans have to appreciate that. He's a too talented team.
All right, the alley-oop pass to Bowie. From Orr, and that ties the game. Orr and Bowie put on the Louis Bowie show to tie the ball game. Arnold, foul line extended. Shoots over Bowie, and Iowa jumps ahead again by a fair point on the field goal by Arnold. A six, still a six. Rebounded by Iowa to one of little men, Arnold. It's the guy in the middle, Lester now, running through the timeline. Moss has Arnold, and now they switch. And now they switch back. And Jennifer plays Moyle into the lane, and now shoots to the right side. Shoots to the other side, and it's missed by Lester. Rebounded by Orr, and the arms are on the run. Jennifer at the foul line, six tied up. It's tied up by Lester, and it'll be a jump ball.
Syracuse is coming down with full court zone pressure with Lewis Orr on the ball at 6'8", and that's got to be a tough pass. They're dropping back man for man. I expect that Iowa will try to go inside and try to get a couple of fouls on Bowie, who has been fouled from.
Back to Arnold at Iowa. Lester from the foul line, little bit short, rebounded head, and Syracuse goes on the run. In the early going, Bucky, both these clubs looking like they love to run and gun. Head foul out. Big time jumping, no good.
Both teams like the up-tempo. Syracuse is a bit deeper. Iowa goes with about 7, maybe 8. So if this pace continues, it has to favor the top-seeded Orange.
Bucky, I had honestly expected Iowa not to milk the clock so much, but Iowa to run a little bit more of a control ball game.
Well, they usually do. If they don't get the transition, which is their best game, they're usually very patient. We're beginning to see that now.
3:30 at the first half is complained. 16 footer by Boyle, and that's his third basket. Kevin Boyle with 6 points. Iowa has a 4-point lead at 10-6, 4 minutes into the first half. Head's down to shoot. Don't shoot from that angle. Standing for the freshman. Head will shoot from there. And it's off the back of the rim. There's going to be a rebound foul on
on Roosevelt Tour, who in the last Syracuse ball game fouled out. Jim Boeheim signaling his club, settle down, keep taking it to him. Boeheim's club picks up their first foul. Iowa's only been charged with one foul. That was picked up earlier by Ben Brookins. Iowa, after 4 minutes and 10 seconds, with a 10-6 lead.
Two superb matchups. One right here with Moss versus Lester in the back door. The other one inside, Bowie and Cass Fisher.
Right ball played by Satterfield. He's looking for either Lester or Arnold and finds Brookins with a 17-foot shot. The rebound, Cass Fisher. That's the third, and he's going to get for a 3-point goal. That's the foul by Marty Hare.
Steve Cass Fisher. A transfer from the University of North Carolina, was on their runner-up team in 77. He hits the offensive board, takes it right back up, doesn't put it on the floor, takes it right through Roosevelt Bowie with a second foul. As we said, Bowie is foul-prone. The miraculous thing about their win last week, a decisive win over Villanova, is that Bowie played very little, got an early foul trouble, and the Syracuse bench played extremely well, especially game three.
All right, Brad Fisher with a 3-point play. Plus a 7-point Iowa lead after only 4.5 minutes. Granted for the freshman, played kind of tight by Boyle. Arnold laying off head. Head won't get penetrated that much. In the Bowie, knocked away by Cass Fisher. Cass Fisher got a good quick hand and batted the ball away. So Iowa with a chance down a length of the lead. Lester penetrates. Can't score. It's off Iowa. Is up by as many as 7. Within a minute of the ball game, led 4-0. Led 10-6 4 minutes in the game, and now 5 minutes in the game, is up by 7-13-6.
Iowa trying to front all the inside postmen. Syracuse very adept at throwing the alley-oop a lot fast. There has to be pressure on the guard. If they lay off the Syracuse guard, two things are going to happen. One, they can all shoot it from out there. And secondly, they can throw that lob pass.
The Syracuse turnover, they also stop the clock. A timeout on the floor with a score. Iowa 13, Syracuse 6. Entirely due to Syracuse turnovers, Syracuse has already turned the ball over 4 times in the early going.
Moss has done a good job on Lester. Right to that shot, he's 0 for 4.
Lester drove to the weak side, had the ball knocked away. But maybe luck is firing on Iowa. They got the ball right back again. Moss, extremely tight to Lester. And he played Lester that way most of the ball game. Arnold looking for Lester. And Cam Kitchen missed an easy layup. He should have given him a 9-point lead of 15-6 and still a still save at 13-6. Jennifer, in the bully, the shooter. He shot off the glass. Here is Arnold on the run. A 2-on-1 break. Lester by head. Lester go right by head. And Lester has scored his first field goal. He is 1-for-5 from the floor. It's 15-6 Iowa.
Iowa very impressive in transition. The smaller lineup gives them more quickness. They're giving up a little inside, but they're impressive so far.
All right, that is Satterfield using the glass. The freshman out of Ann Arbor has 4. Syracuse's 8 points, and now the Orangemen in Stuart Bruin. Bruin replaces head. Tony Bruin out of Astoria, New York, a hot shot high school here a year ago, a 6'4 freshman up at Syracuse this year.
Well, he's really a small forward trying to make the transition to guard. With this backcourt by Syracuse, I think they're vulnerable to pressure.
Well, that's the second time now within the last 90 seconds or so that they have flooded one side. And they try to give Lester the weak side one-on-one drive against Moss. In the process, Moss has fouled. First foul on Eddie Moss. 3-2 fouls. Syracuse. Iowa's going to get in Bobby Hanson right now. Hanson will replace Lester. So more maybe Kenny Arnold now will do most of the floor leading for these Iowa Hawkeyes. 13-3 to go in the opening half. Iowa's got a 7-point lead of 15-8. Deep right shot, scored by Brookins, and the rebound, Lady Luck smiles again on Iowa. In the Brookins, he loses the handle. Bruin on the run with Eddie Moss. Back to Bruin, and off inside to the unexpected Santa Fe. Sanford did not expect the pair.
Give credit to Boyle, too, hustling back. He put forth such a great effort in the first round games in Greensboro. Norm Sloan, the NC State coach, called him the bionic man.
All right, after the steal by Eddie Marsh, Bobby Hansen quickly reached in, and maybe a good thing he did reach in. Bobby Hansen has fouled Jim Boeheim, Syracuse club.
Jim Boeheim always looks like he's an agony. He's only won 100 games and lost 17. It's incredible. He never seems to enjoy it. What a fine career he's had. And that 100 wins and 17 losses is in 4 years.
Iowa in a 2-3 zone. Syracuse is outside them right now. Our Marge and Bruin like the ball. Sanders in the corner. They're playing Orr inside the zone. Bruin has scored four. This is the 6th point of the ball game. 15-10. Iowa's lead drops off to 5. It had been 9 at 15-6. It is now 15-10 with 12 and a half minutes to play in the first half. Bobby Hansen, the freshman, hitting the big guy transition. In the shooter and the scorer, Kevin Boyle. Boyle leads everybody with 8 points. 17-10, the Hawkeyes. Penetration. 13 for the Marsh. Rebound, Bowie. And Bowie scores. Bowie matches Boyle with 8 points. It is 17-12, Iowa by 5. Syracuse loves to pressure the ball, but Arnold is about to break the pressure. He hits Hansen. Down the middle goes Hansen, knocked away by Eddie Marsh, and Marsh has picked up his second foul.
The three-quarter court press by Syracuse, a 1-2-2, has really taken Iowa out of their stuff, and I also think they missed Lester at the point. They just haven't had the direction since he's been out, and I expect Lute Olson will send him back in very quickly.
There's Steve Wade for Iowa, first appearance tonight. He replaces Vince Brookins. Wade, much bigger, but not as good a scorer. Wade is 6'10". He is a junior out of Iowa City, and here returning again is Ronnie Lester for Kenny Arnold.
Both teams will zone along the baseline out of bounds, which is a very smart thing to do.
All right, Lester fires the inbound pass. Boyle exchanging outside with Lester. You see Lester's right knee wrap. He's got knee problems this year. Boyle from the baseline, and there's a rebound foul. It's on Iowa, and it's called on Patterson. That is his first personal foul, and that is the third team foul on the Hawkeyes. Despite the fact we've got a quick moving, running game from one end to the other, Buffy, it has not been a foul play per se.
No, I think the officials are letting them play, and I'm glad to see that. It's a shame when you get to this level of competition and it's a brush foul free throw shooting contest.
Kyle Sloan, pretty good outside shooter, is now in the ball game for Syracuse. Sloan coming out to beat the ball, but it's stopped away, and then retrieved by Orr. The rebound foul is on. I believe it's on Bruin. If it is, it'll be his second.
These are the kind of fouls that this coach is gray hairs. Or trying to put it in the paint, too crowded, no place to go. Really forces up a little jumper. It's off to the back of the iron. And they call Roosevelt Bruin for coming over the back of Scott Fisher.
So Bruin is replaced by Junior Dan Shays out of DeWitt, New York. The son of a great NBA star. Game over Iowa, back it goes to the line. Dan Shays wearing number 44, and he will play down low where Bruy has been. Syracuse is scoring, flip between Bruy and Sanders to a ball 12 points. Stop of the D.R., he'll turn it over. That's either 6 or 7 Syracuse turnovers.
Normally, in fact, all year long, they have forced over 100 more turnovers than their opponent. That's good pressure defense. It's also Roosevelt Bowie in that lane who makes people change high percentage shots at the last minute.
Syracuse just turned over the ball for the 6th time within the first 8 minutes and 45 seconds. 11:15 to go in the first half. Iowa has led from the opening set. It is now up to 17-12. Good lead by as much as 15-6.
Boyle running that baseline, trying to get through. He was the rookie of the year in the Big Ten last year. Only a sophomore. What a sensational competitor he is.
Lester charging into Bruin, and they call him for a travel. A travel call against Lester. Marty Hudson's back in the Syracuse lineup, and they give a rest to number 40, the Ann Arbor freshman, Eric Sanderson. So it's Cone with the ball and going right towards Lester. Lester trying to force him Cone to the right side. He's looking for him. He's going to find him. To Bruin. To Orr. And they pick up more quickly at the foul line. Dan Chase on a head coach. And he got fouled by Jeff Kitchen. And that's the second for the senior out of Chicago.
Dan Chase normally doesn't go for the basket. His strength is a nice shooting touch. Jeff Kitchen, good pass here by Lewis Orr, beating the post. Jeff Kitchen looking for the jump shot. Chase gives him a good pump fake. Once he gets Jeff Kitchen off his feet, he leans in, makes sure there's contact.
Dan Chase, he played a real solid 24 minutes of relief against Villanova. When Dewey was in foul trouble, he's got two shots right here. Like his dad in bygone years, pretty good foul shooter. Dan Chase, 78% this year. His dad shot that well and even better in the pros.
Good release, lots of problems here.
Chase made the second shot, 17-13, 4-2-5 by 4. Bit of trouble involved by Arnold, and a quick release to Lester. Bobby Hedger plays him to one side, going to the other in the zone.
This is surprising. They've got some fouls to waste now. The pressure was effective.
Chase, the middle man, is off. The outside runners are ahead and gone. Here is by Arnold. There's a foul on Bruin of Syracuse. And that is Bruin's first. This is the one time to go through town. Occupy slowing down. He's playing 15 seconds to show Bucky. The shooter will be Kenny Arnold, only the sophomore out of Chicago. His season high, 27 against Minnesota. He's got one of those cool nicknames out of Midwest. They refer to Kenny Arnold as the Iceman.
Well, he'd have to be cool. He had 9 assists at Indiana, and that's not easy to do.
18, 16, Iowa by 5, 19, 16. Arnold, a 76% foul shooter, has 4 points tonight. The overplay of Lester against Cohen, trying to force him to left side, right towards Marty Harris. In the way to Chase. Foul by ball, yes, by ball. And that's 7 balls, 3 fouls. Chase with a right back to the line.
Well, it looks like they've earned some respect, and I'm talking about they being Syracuse. They're going to Dan Chase, just like they did the Roosevelt Bowie early on. So obviously the game plan for the Orange is to go inside at every opportunity.
Would you say, Bucky, that Iowa's done a decent job setting off Syracuse's inbound game?
Yeah, but Syracuse does some nice things, and this is going to be about all night long. And I go back to the point of Syracuse's three people. Lute Olson, a fine Syracuse. He was coach of the year last year in the Big Ten and scored it this year. He just doesn't have the numbers.
Dan Chase, 2-for-4 in the line of the night. Keeps the game, 19-14 Iowa. Lead pass on. Boone picks him up quickly. And rebounded to Syracuse to Lewis Orr. Cohen is on the run. Good. Back to Cohen. They're looking for Bruin. Shooting over on over very short. The rebound to Chase. The rebound to Orr. And now the loose ball to Brookins. Arnold with Lester, and Lester, they just allow the basket,
Patel's mighty head stuck a hand in there. Last time he held his ground for Patel, this time he tried to make a steal. You better be pretty careful. He's going to move on. He's really back in the place as low as they are still, dude. One of the last years of 15 hour games this year because of the NCAA. When he hit fire, he won 13 of the 14 games in which he took part. Lester just picked up his fourth card. He is a 79% foul shooter. Two for two from the line. A 7-point Iowa lead. Iowa has never trailed this game. Away from the ball. Hold on, Curry. Curry. So almost a 36 layout. Puts it in. Curry has 3 fouls. They did play well without Curry, but he is he's the key to so many things that they do, especially the defense. Lewis Roy has just replaced an Iowa shooting right arm with Steve Roy. They got the hit, rebound, back to Moore over the first game. Lester plays hard to the game. Arnold lays off him. James can move on away.
This lead might be bigger, but you have to, don't go away, folks. Syracuse is for real, and they're going to come back quicker. Right now, the Iowa defense has been the difference because Syracuse has played well without Curry before. That is not the key factor.
Marty Eddy has the ball. Yes, to score tonight. Neither has Foster has the ball. He's got it for only the freshman. And as he
goes in low to Lewis Roy, a foul by Brookins of Iowa, and that is number two on Brookins, a junior out of Cleveland.
They depend on Orange inside and outside, particularly the two in that inner. And Lester's doing a great job on this, and underneath Brookins is just been sensational. He's giving away about 3 inches, but he's out pushing in front of Moore, and with the pressure on the guard, it's been difficult to get the ball inside.
All right, but now on bonus time, and Lewis Moore is to the foul line. He's the number 6 man in the all-time Syracuse University scoring base. He's got his clutch shot coming. 3 points for Moore. An outstanding down at the line this year, 84%. Tony Dillon is at the recording table, ready to come in the 4-3 final. After he goes 2 for 2, Bruins replaces the scoreless Marty Hill. So Bruins ends up with Mark, Thor, Jennifer, and Sage against Donald, Lester, Boyle, Waite, and Brookins. Here's Lester, not a half a year ago before he had the new driver. Brookins from the corner. Broke down by Brookins, Lester and Hill. I mean, Lester and Mark both for it, just going major hit. Both of them playing each other. Off the hands of Lewis Orr, and Iowa will come up the floor with a 29-18 lead. 5:50 to go, it's been down. Looks pretty interesting. Lester's third hit, and then Sam came back. And Bruin right towards the skin of Arnold.
Thank you.
side half. Here he takes it to the hoop. Look at Tuffy Red Bruin coming from the other side. A 42-inch third of the lead. Lute Olson doesn't look like he has the lead, but he does. By time. There is his next field to take over for Rochelle Cooley as the starting center. Extra 32-24. 4 minutes, 30 seconds on the two fan clock. Syracuse. Good pass here by Doyle. Goes over the top. Very trying to find his feet. Wade trying to get squared away before he goes back up. Couple of feet. All right, Syracuse trying to get shots down. Final 4 minutes. And after taking shots on the scoreboard, 32-24. Brookins left hand in the middle of the Olson's positioning on Billy and trying to help on all those penetrations. Lester, who had a 5-point first shot right to the baseline. The same kind of shot. Didn't go on her. Head pass almost to the set. The ball is by Arnold. The ball is going to shot. The left ball and left ball. That's a left to set the amount. Jim Boeheim has beside himself. There was a heck of a collision out there on that intercepted ball. Of course, we mentioned that the officials were letting them play. That was definitely no harm, no foul. All right, less than 19 minutes to go. Here's Johnny Field with a Syracuse lead. Moore in the corner, deep in the shoot ahead. Head hasn't scored yet. Moore rebound for Iowa. Lester, Brookins is second shot for Moore. Thank you. baseline. The little going down there easy, trying to get the foul. Kings with the shot, lays it off to Dan Chase, who's in good position, and he draws the foul.
But Chase for the goal in the first half after 3 fouls, he scored 5 points.
Junior Dan Chase now has 6. A 50-49 CFP3. Chase and Junior out of the CFP suburb of the world. To 51-49. And Iowa finds the middle of that zone press. They're very tough. They're keeping them setting it down in the second half. Here's the pass system. The arm goes out of that corner. The rebound is Bruin. Bruin and Sanderson locked out the board. The very, very neutral. Big guy stays, you see. See the Hawkeyes doing what they do best with their quickness. They get the steal. Ronnie Lester in the middle with the ball, and that's a guarantee. A nice pass inside. Arnold takes it to the hole. Dave mumbling to himself all the way down the floor. They're letting that ball be stolen from him. Makes the foul at the other end. Jenny Arnold, one of many, now running wounded. This is his free throw. And now we wait for the second one. Now Clark coming out for Eddie March. So Syracuse sacrifices. And a little bit of a better shooter. All right, ball's in play on Arnold's second. And no good free throw again. Leading partner with 18. Syracuse's bench product is Cullen, Bruin, and
and save. Ball over Santafer. 14 to 4. Over the 53, 51. Iowa trails by 2. 17 to Orr. Looks like he's on his way for another big game. Hawkeyes get 29 points and 17 rebounds this year against a fine St. John's team that was also in this NCAA tournament. Lute Olson was trying to break for the hoop, and then Dawn passed it right behind him. Just a definitely laboring. I'm not sure if it's the trigger or the injury. He's laboring. The high kick by Boyle did not help out Lester. Bobby Hanson from the foul line extended to the shooter Boyle. The rebound is cross-distance, and it can't hold on. He'll feel all right. I wonder how the cheerleader might feel. But he has good taste anyway. Put the shooter. 8:48 left on the clock. Syracuse with a three-point lead, 53, with the offense. I have seen man for man. He's going, running deep down the floor. He's feeling all the time. There go in the Santafer, and he's been fouled by Bobby Hayden. Santafer carries it with you along the baseline. The freshman, the man out of Michigan, takes the pass from Santafer. Wisely, doesn't put it on the floor, puts it right back up in traffic. Santafer, although only a freshman, has been starting most of the year. Jim Boeheim called him too. This ball plus two. He's going for 11. Now he's going to go for 12. He gives his club a 54-51 lead. Eddie Hawk coming in today on stage. He was using his Hawk to going for the game. Rotating his backcourt again. Trying to wear the Hawkeyes down. Hawk's got himself a good run. That is his second free throw coming. If he turns it, it'll be a 4-point lead. 55-51. Syracuse. Is up by 4, 57-53. Mark is shot, blocked by Clark Bishop. It goes to Hanson. 13-3, Bobby Hanson. Saves. Back over the rebound. Here's Mark, running by Lester. That is a foul by Boyle. He didn't say so, but he now has 4 fouls. 4 fouls by Boyle. This was off the press. Miracle doing a great job on the point. Forces the high pass. Eddie Moss, well rested, coming off the paint. He puts it back to side. And it's the last part of the double play. Lewis Orange nails it. That door having up his 19 points to 35-year-old Jim Boeheim. So when he came to Syracuse as a freshman, in the early 60s of the ball pass, came to town without a scholarship. Yeah, he was a walk-on, and I was coaching at West Virginia at the time, and I wanted him to shoot more. And the reason I wanted him to shoot more was the other guy, the guy that I'm in, the Dave Young. Jim Boeheim is a very low-key ball player in uniform. He's a low-key guy, off the floor, no clothes, but on the floor, he's going to shoot. Iowa down by 4. Lester penetrating. Lester stands. Trying to stay with Eddie Moss. Or a fair score.
Just
the money man. Save, top of the key. Moore drops it up. And Orr is fouled by, they don't call it on Brookins, I think.
Well, the chance to see the rebounding is intense to say the least. Dan Carey with a good release. A little push in the seven underneath there. Orr and Sonny that run on that offensive board, but Orr is going to shoot.
Lewis Orr, Syracuse is fifth with consistency with 21. Syracuse needs players. They're going to get the bonus. Orr going after his 23rd point. If he hits, Syracuse will be down by three. 5 minutes to play.
Moss made a move on him. Johnny Lester really didn't react very well, and he's some kind of quick when he's right.
Lester on a weak side drive. He forced up a hook shot. The rebound is good. Who scores against Cage?
The clear out for Lester. It wasn't a very good shot, but it hung on the rim cross, and Wade put it away.
Moss working on Lester. He's left it by Wade. A 5-point lead for Iowa. Brookins trying to make it 7. He gets fouled as he knocks down Cage.
The good Iowa defense, backing in. Eddie Moss looking for somebody to give it to. Takes it inside, almost doesn't get it out of his hands. Speedway starts to fall apart with the tip. And at the other end, Dan Carey falls for the block. He was moving in.
A good call. Nick Simmons, the junior out of Cleveland. He's coached Jonathan Russell earlier this year. They're the Hawkeyes, the winner of the North Western. Brookins, the starter tonight, now has 10 points. He was not a starter against North Carolina State. He came off the bench and scored 17. Going to his 11. 70 to 63. They're trying to go to Lewis Orr, but Brookins is cutting off the passing lane.
Shooter at first to be in a hot streak, and he's getting all he wants in the transition. The pressure by Syracuse is now being solved by Iowa, at least to the point of getting the jumper.
Santa Fe, rebounded, saved, caught. The shooter is through him. The rebound, Santa Fe, got away with a push. He's cut it by Wade. To Lester, and it took it easy. Lester. Owens back in the game, trying to give Syracuse some offense. One of the better shooters. They need him from flowing. They did not get it from Marty Eckenheim. They had to see great offensive development from Lute Olson. He did get it from Bowie before he fouled out. Here's Gore on another basket. And he really leaned out of Cincinnati, who has a 23-point game. 74-67. Stays near the foul line. Stops the drive of Brookins. 3 minutes to play. The steal by Santa Cruz. The lead to Moss.
Nobody in the lane.
ball out right under the basket, which means that he cannot throw a long pass without hitting the back of that backboard. So the smart, the Syracuse pressure is up, making the fourth, the short pass, which gives him a chance to double team. Actually, there are people open down the floor, so he's got to clear away from that glass so he can find them.
Jim Boeheim, the number one team this year in the East. Being handled tonight by a team that's down for 4 points in the season.
Yes, but a team that's played the major part of their season without their best player, All-American Ronnie Russell. Of course, Syracuse has rated as high as second this year for a long time, and it was a deserved rating. Right now, or at least in the final poll, in both their wire services, they finished fifth. Another superior year for Syracuse, perhaps frustration in NCAA play, but another good year.
Palmer makes it 83-73, 40 seconds to go. Dave, overweight. Dave with his first second half basket. 35 seconds to go. Dave is back all along. Brookins hammers it right in. King Brookins with an outstanding game again tonight. 17 for Iowa. Set it down by Arnold with 23 seconds. Iowa leads by 5. About that Syracuse for what it also did against NC State and Virginia Commonwealth. The inside score is doing. Roney doing. And Syracuse wants to talk it over with 18 seconds to play, but trailing 84-77.
Same things like Syracuse has got to draw some fouls, get to that free throw line without the clock moving. It is possible. Looking forward to that matchup. Without Syracuse, Georgetown really, particularly on their record here in the East, has to be, in my opinion, the favorite, again because of their depth. But this Iowa team has been a credit to themselves and certainly to the Big Ten.
Both Bruin and Eddie Hawes got a man down to Bruin. I got a man down to Brooklyn. And they draw the foul. Brookins had bench product in the last Iowa game when it defeated North Carolina State. He had 17 in the second half. Jim Boeheim talking with his freshman, Eric Sanderson. Now they're trying to cool off Brookins, but I don't think they're going to be able to cool him off. He had a 6-point first half. He's had an 11-point second half. Brookins averaging just over 10 points a game. He is well above that again tonight. Here's a look at Brookins, as every other Iowa ball player is back here in midcourt.
The reason they're back there, they don't want to stop the clock with a foolish foul off the missed free throw. They're just going to lay back and pick up their man as they come down the floor, trying to make Syracuse labor a little bit. Absolutely no foul.
85-76. Brookins dead shoot, 76% from the line, and there's the score. 86-77. 15 seconds. Bruin, right by Wayne, and blocked by Brookins. And knocked down to Lester with 10 seconds. Hammer scores. 88-77. An hour advances to the Sunday afternoon battle against the Maryland or Georgetown. We'll be back to bring you higher.